weeks are over. It's all about football all the time as we're underway here in week 13. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. So the Cincinnati Bengals, they've won a couple in a row, most recently this last weekend over Cleveland, now at 5-6. Look at Andy Dalton. Hey, Dalton, career best 5 straight games now without throwing an interception.
The name is Dalton. Well done, Andy. Well done. And how about this? When the Bengals want to get right, they look for the Browns on the schedule, don't they? Because when they play the Browns, that's when the offense goes into high gear. Best offensive outing since beating the Browns earlier this year. 2 of the wins against the Browns.
Give me that one more time.
The name is Dalton. Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Tyler Kroft, the tight end, the one he was looking for. And it's 3rd and short. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
Now the rookie from Oklahoma, it's Joe Mixon. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on 4th down. For Joe Mixon, you know, Charles, he had a good game last week against the Browns. He hit the 100-yard mark for the first time in his career.
Yeah, had a late 11-yard touchdown run in the 4th quarter. Only the 2nd time this season that the Bengals were able to rush for more than 100 yards. Joe Mixon, the rookie out of Oklahoma, leading the way.
Breaks the tackle, now an alley, still going. And he goes out of bounds, just shy of the 45. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on 1st down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. It's caught inside the 25. And he takes this down deep into Cincinnati territory. And that one results in 35 yards.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gainer. That's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. If you hit enough crossers and underneath.
And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Remember what
he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
And he'll put it through to make it 7-0 Steelers. Boswell on now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch.
And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Bud Dupree, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. So the D gets the sack on first, and now it brings up 2nd down. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 12.
no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
Now Brown. Brown with his stick skills. It's a 47-yard punt, but they did give up 10 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Now Roethlisberger on first down. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 7 yards the pickup on the pitch and catch. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle, and they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Roethlisberger now to throw on third down. And James has it. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Roethlisberger to his big target, James. All 6-7 of him for a Steeler first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there. And he's got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. Just a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Now Roethlisberger to throw on 2nd down. Man open left side is Brown. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. By the way, Charles, on Antonio Brown, he did it again last week. 169 yards, 2 touchdowns in the win over Green Bay.
And how about the catch? All right, I know the catch is a phrase associated with the 49ers and Dallas Cowboys. Mm-hmm. But this one in this game, Pittsburgh's going to come up with a name for it. Because what Antonio Brown did, catching the ball, dragging that second foot, that was absolutely amazing. No one thought he actually caught the ball.
It was unreal. Yeah, and the week before he had the one-handed catch that he trapped on the side of his helmet in the end zone. I mean, yeah, he's on the move here. They've got it 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they showed to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle. Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise...
And he's in! Touchdown, Pittsburgh! Le'Veon Bell, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. Boswell for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. Boswell on now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Second down, Dalton. And he's got room. Now he's hit, and Dalton lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet there are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. It's a quick turnaround for them after the turnover, but the way they moved it on their last drive, they're probably eager to get right back at it.
And you know me, and you know my tendencies in this situation. What do I want right now?
Be aggressive.
Be aggressive. Take your shot right here.
And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. Just a one-yard pickup on the play, and it's a second down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. 12 yards that time at a Pittsburgh first.
That's a good-looking play to me. The big tight end on a crossing route coming underneath. Sometimes he can gain some serious momentum going forward, can't he?
Yeah, he can indeed, and pretty well executed there. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
A good number of coaches, at any time they call an in route, are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get five out of the keeper, but now it's third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. Scrambling, not particularly a Roethlisberger strong suit, but he does get the job done there and gets a first. To go here in the first half. We'll come back to Cincinnati after this. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in.
That will be caught by James, the big tight end, as a Steeler touchdown. Jesse James, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to draw up those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. It worked out for six. Boswell on now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. So now the Bengal offensive unit back out onto the field. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here. Or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes.
Now he's hit, and Dalton lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. The 40. Past the 20. And he's in for six and a Steeler touchdown. This first half has been a nightmare for that offense. Defense just dominating them.
And when you're picking up the ball, picking up their mistakes, and taking it the other way and putting it in the end zone, that's a defense's dream. They're having that type of a game.
Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong for this offensive unit. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. Fielded about a yard deep. Room here to run. And it'll be a terrific return here as he gets it down all the way inside the 30.
Well, whatever the relationship was between the special teams and the offense, it's gotten a heck of a lot closer after a return like that. The special teams just keep setting them up. The offense thinks they'll go out there and knock them down.
Andy Dalton. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
His throw caught right around the six. And out of bounds, just shy of the end zone at the one. A very solid gain of 27. So we have now seen connection number one between Dalton and Adriel Jeremiah, A.J. Green.
Say that again.
Adriel Jeremiah.
Look at you. You are full of knowledge.
Now he's hit, and Dalton lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. He's at the 50, 30, the 20, 10, and he's in for six and a Steeler touchdown. This first half has been a nightmare for that offense. Defense just dominating them.
And when you're picking up the ball, picking up their mistakes, and taking it the other way and putting it in the end zone, that's a defense's dream. They're having that type of a game.
Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong for this offensive unit. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Steelers' defense getting ready here. And for their efforts so far, they deserve a little defensive montage here.
I like that. I like how you recognize what they're doing out there and how much fun they're having, because that's indeed what's going on. beating them to the punch just about every snap now, swarming, swooping, taking the ball away. This is a lot of fun to watch.
Opportunistic, right?
Very much so.
They'll start here with a give to Mixon. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
So we are at halftime here on a Monday night as we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Bengals have been worked over in the first half and trail big right now. The Steelers took control of the game, and unless something drastic changes, it seems like they might be able to coast the victory. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. First and 10. Here a throw deep down the field is caught, and he'll end up at the 20-yard line before being tackled. Steelers later on the drive. It's Roethlisberger finding his wideout, Juju Smith-Schuster. And it ends up working for a touchdown as they get out to a 7-0 lead. Steelers take it early in the second. Bell's going to stay between the tackles, and he kept off the long drive with a touchdown. As they move out in front, 14-0. Now after the fumble, Roethlisberger's on target here, and he caps off the six-play drive with the score. Steelers up now by 21. Now first and 10. Dupree's going to knock the ball free here. Steelers recover the ball and return it for a touchdown. The Steelers with a commanding lead. Bengals now late in the second. We're going to get a fumble here. Steelers recover the ball and return it for a touchdown. Steelers in control. So that'll do it for us at the EA's.
Back now in Cincinnati. And this is a blowout so far as we get. So they almost turn it over there. Scary moment. Second down here. Dalton here from the gun. And the grab by Croft. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down.
I just make this one simple. Could he be any more open than he was on that play?
And they lost him going to the outside.
Hard to believe because you go through your accounting on each and every defensive snap. Who's got who? What defense you're in? That was totally a blown coverage.
And it's a short one here. Complete to the tight end. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Love the effort. Love the dramatics. Getting the feet down. How about a little step shuffle along the sideline there, almost like a great ballet dancer or a tap dancer. All for no gain, though?
I was going to say, it's so pretty, and it gets you nothing. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the Steelers are going to take over first and 10. Deep in their own territory. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. Bell so light on his feet and brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. That one good for 14 yards in a Steeler first.
Well, Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, what you're saying is maybe if it takes you one or two more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. Really hurts the team on defense.
12 yards that time at a Pittsburgh first.
I know we're in the era of wide open football, a lot of spread formations, more space. But there's still a spot for power football, and we just saw some of it right there. How about that run?
Yeah, breaking the tackle, and, you know, late in this game, he wants the football in his hands. He's had a good day. Now a first down carry by Bell, and no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. On second down, it's Bell. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
On third down, here's Bell. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
Yeah, let me puff out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. That was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
And he was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling
again. No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
Passing again. Dalton on second and 10. Green's got it over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 17 at a Cincinnati first down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
To throw here, Dalton. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And he's brought down. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Now Dalton with a first and 10. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And Dalton to throw. Looking sideline, incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Passing, it's Dalton. And able to find Green. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first. It's do or die for Dalton. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. So Charles, are able to complete what so often seems to be elusive, a shutout in the NFL. And maybe what's fitting is they ended the game on the field, that defensive unit on the field. What an exclamation mark.
And probably felt like they could go another 60 minutes without anyone putting points on the board against them. That's the confidence you gain throughout when you're pitching a shutout, and they're gonna leave the stadium feeling like they're all 10 feet tall.
So for the Steelers, they continue to be one of the best teams around as they move to 10-2. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for Cincinnati, it was a win they needed to turn the season around, but instead, they fall to 5-7. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against the Chicago Bears. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. From Cincinnati, good night, everybody.